This episode of DNews is brought to you by Audible. Call if you must, bad rhyming a disease. It gives men happiness or leaves them at ease. But why do we rhyme, my fellow DNewsers? It's in your brain, the cells and the users. Hey guys, Trace here. Thanks for tuning in today for some DNews. Monday was International Limerick Day, celebrating the birthday of British writer Edward Lear, who popularized limericks in his mid-19th century work, A Book of Nonsense. Rhymes are fun, son, but rhyme is a lot more than just finishing sentences with similar words, because that's for the birds. Okay, I'll stop. There's alliteration and assonance, there's consonants and syllabic rhyme, and a whole lot of other ones. Rhyming has as much to do with the rhythm of speech and language as it does with the systematic use of certain vowels or consonants. Rhyme is common in Arabic and English, parts of the Quran and the Bible both use rhyme, and the earliest example of rhyme is from the 10th century in China. Because Japanese has so few sounds in their language, their poetry is based on double meanings and wordplay, while in China, they use the breadth of their tonal language to create a musical pattern. Rhyming is around, but it's different everywhere. For humans, rhyme is processed in language, but also as music. A study in memory and cognition found adults who sang while learning picked up a new language much faster than those who were speaking. A study in infant behavior and development asked pregnant women to read The Cat in the Hat aloud every day of their third trimester, and then after birth, newborns responded when they heard the words from The Cat in the Hat. As regular DNews viewers will probably remember, music has a huge influence on the human brain, with rhyme connected deeply with our expression of that. We've been built with an understanding of music, and though related, rhyme is processed a little differently. Using various brain scanners, researchers at Stanford found beta and gamma brain waves correlate or sync up when subjects listened to music. When listening to rhythm and rhyme, we naturally try and predict where the next beat is going to fall. Separately, a study published in the journal Nature pointed an FMRI at the brains of both men and women to see how they processed rhyming differently. When brains heard regular language, they lit up all over, but when they heard rhyme, it was sublime. Okay, I said I'd stop, but I'm not gonna. The FMRI showed activity in the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, part of the executive function and language processing centers of the brain. Interestingly, while women use both sides of their brain to process rhyme, men only use the left side. We'll come back to that. So, TLDR, why do we like rhyming? Well, a study in evolutionary psychology puts it like this. Men are going to dress to impress with both attire and language. Men have a penchant for becoming linguistically loquacious when presented with an affable member of their preferred procreative coital captivation. One way to show wit is with words. Nothing preempts a pithy partner. According to the study, people would reach into their vocabulary and pull out those rare, larger, more complex words to show off their mental fitness and prove themselves worthy partners. If you recall, women use more of their brain to process rhyme, so perhaps these are related. Poetry is the language of love. Pity the perturbed pea brain, for their prose cannot proliferate a predilection for their, you know what I mean. Write your favorite rhymes in the comments below, lyrics, raps, poems, you name it. And if you want to know more about rhyming, check out audible.com. They've got hours of audiobooks on poetry. I really enjoy Scottish poet Robbie Burns. Poems like Ga Hi a Haggis and I Fond Kiss, which sound tough, but they're actually not. You can find this and 100,000 other works on audible.com and download a free book of your choice by going to audiblepodcast.com/dnews. Check it out. Please subscribe for more DNews, and y'all are great. See you later.